Hey guys, Dr. Carlo here. I'm just finishing my shift at 8:30 at night. It's been a long day. I started shift at 11. The air was already packed and had some people that waited a little while, so I started seeing a lot of people. I saw probably like 6-7 people in the first hour. And I knew I had a meeting coming up at 3 o'clock, so I needed to keep things moving. And just the day never stopped. I was just so busy the whole day. I was running room after room after room. In 9.5 hour shift, which is what I worked, 11 to 8:30, I saw 31 patients, which is a lot. It's like 3 point something an hour, which for a medium acuity emergency department is pretty busy. The bad thing is, you know, I saw all those patients, but I have all the charts to do. So if it takes me an average of 3 minutes to do every chart, so that's 30 patients, that's 90 minutes. So I have a choice to do. It's 8:30 at night. Do I go home, see my kids, put them to bed, kiss them and stuff, but then fall asleep because I'm too tired, and then do them tomorrow? Or do I stay here and do them now, but then don't see the kids, and they'll be at bed and stuff? So those are the kind of things that ER doctors go through, and it's kind of upsetting because I'm already tracking some charts from the day before I didn't finish, so I'm just going to have to come in early and try to do those. But it was a good day overall. I was busy. I saw a lot of people. Nobody was really sick. Well, one, we ended up intubating her. She came with respiratory difficulty. And when we did the ABG, the pH was very acidotic. Her CO2 was up, so we put her on BiPAP. We gave her some diuretics because she was also retaining some fluid. And she went to the ICU. But other than that one, everybody else was okay. I admitted a few more for chest pain, trouble breathing, bronchitis, weakness. Did a couple abscess drainages. Nothing really exciting. But I'm really excited that this is like my second video in this office. My office is finally finished, and I got my own space in the emergency department to do this and to work on my charts and do what I need to do. So it's kind of like, 8 feet by 8 feet, and it's really cool. I'm really excited. I got my diplomas up there. Let me see if I can show you. Let's see. I got my medical school stuff, my diploma from college, my diploma from residency, my Alpha Omega Alpha deal thing. Oh, this one fell down. This is kind of cool. It's a medal for our trauma center in St. Luke's Hospital. They had a Night of Heroes, and they awarded me a medal there. And hey, it's just kind of cool. I'm not showing off. I'm just showing you the office. Got a couple books back here that I brought for home. They were in the garage in a box, so finally I have some space to put them in and work on these kind of things. So I think I'm going to do a couple of these kind of videos, a little video diary log or something. Kind of go through my mind, choose some things. If you don't like this format, then don't watch them. I don't care. I have fun doing it. But I'm really psyched about this. They just came out today. Ever since we opened the new year, and those you guys that follow me in my videos and stuff, I've shown you like clips of the ER, how it was getting done. Well, it's finally open. It opened up this Monday, fully and complete. It's been on and off, opening different rooms at a time for the last month or two. But since we opened the new ER, these are our times from arrival to the ER to the time seen by a provider. And you can see we're in the 20 minutes, which is actually pretty good. You were seen by a provider, not necessarily by the doctor, within 20-something minutes, which is, I think, pretty quick. But HCA, Hospitals Corporation of America, and our emergency department have a high goal of 10 minutes. They want us to see an average of the patients 10 minutes. We have a billboard electronically showing wait time is. Actually, if you text the number 2300, put the word ER, it'll ask you for your zip code. And if you put it in, it'll bring in the HCA hospitals who have a wait time, and it'll show you the wait times. Our zip code is 30120, yeah, and if you put that in, the wait time will come up, and that's the average time from arrival to being seen by a provider. Here we have a provider all the way in the front. As soon as you get in, they say hi to you, they grab a little bit of history, they put some orders in. Yeah, it's still going to take you 20-30 minutes to get to the doctor, but at least you get some orders, maybe an x-ray, maybe some labs, and things are started in motion, so the wait time is used adequately. So the other cool thing is our LPMSE, left prior to medical screening exam. This is the number of people who leave without ever seeing a medical provider. They see the nurse or they sign in and they leave. And we've always done very well, but ever since we opened up, we haven't had any. So that's cool. Then our percent AMAs. AMAs are against medical
advised discharges. And the thing is, a lot of people sign in, and then we see them, and then they leave because they go tired of waiting. So we certainly don't want to lose people like that. And we had as much as 5-6%. You can see in February we had a high of 5%, and ever since we opened, we've been either 0 or 1-2%. Our goal is to have 0.5% in LPT, MSE, and then 1.5% on AMA. So a grand total, the two combined, of 1%. We're currently probably like 0.2 plus 1.5, so we're 1.7 or 2%. So we have to work on that yet. But this I'm most excited about, average length of stay for admitted patients. We've never done this before. Look at that. All the admitted patients, 187 minutes, 3 hours in total in the ER before they go upstairs. That's actually pretty good. 3 hours they arrive, they get seen, they get evaluated, admitted, they're upstairs. 3 hours, so that's excellent. Our goal, I think, is 2.5 hours, 150 minutes. And we've always been 5 hours, 5.5 hours, and even more. And then discharge length of stay also improved. Look at that graphic. It's coming down beautifully. And yesterday we had 140 minutes. 2 days before that, we had like 130-something minutes. So, hey, it looks like the new ER is working, and people are coming straight back, and people are getting the care immediately and quickly. And I'm really psyched of what our emergency department is going to do in this community and improve the care of the patients and just really deliver high-quality care. We're going to start working on getting our level 2, well, initially level 3 trauma center accreditation, so we can start seeing some trauma patients. And then once we have the experience and the numbers and the logs, then we can apply for a level 2 trauma center. So that would be awesome. And hopefully patients will keep coming and trust their care to us, and we'll be able to keep providing great care to the people here in Georgia. And I think that's it for tonight. You guys have a good night. Bye-bye.